Very good morning to all the students. Welcome to Fundamentals of Food Processing class. So we have started unit 2. Under that we have started compositional, nutritional and technological aspects of animal meat. So already in lecture 1 we have studied definition of carcass and the concept of red meat and white meat. In lecture 2 we have studied what is the composition of meat, and also we have studied about the marbling of the meat, and based on the marbling how the grading of meat will be done, that is how different grades of meats are classified. So in today's class we are going to study about the postmortem changes in meat and also specifically about the rigor mortis. So to begin with the postmortem changes, nothing but the general consequences which are following after the death of an animal. So soon after the death of animal, there will be stoppage of blood circulation. So since the nerves are broken during the slaughtering, there will be stopping of the blood circulation. So automatically when the blood circulation is stopped, oxygen rate will fall, and also leading to the fall in oxidation and reduction potential. So which may leads to two conditions. So first thing is respiration ceases, second thing is the glycolysis start. So respiration ceases means the conversion of glycogen to carbon dioxide stops, and glycolysis starts means glycogen will be now converted into lactic acid in the absence of oxygen. So what happened when respiration ceases? When respiration ceases, there will be decrease in the ATP and creatine phosphate level. So the energy currency, the ATP production will be reduced, which will create the condition called as rigor mortis, nothing but accumulation of various metabolites, flavor, precursors, etc. Also, it causes the denaturation of proteins, which leads to exudation of fluid and discoloration. So on the other hand, when the glycolysis starts, there will be production of lactic acid, which is an acid, and hence the pH of the animal will fall, and this will leads to the liberation and activation of cathepsin, which causes the protein degradation and which leads to the bacterial growth. So one by one let us see what are the different changes. So following the death of animal, circulation of blood ceases, resulting in complex series of changes within the muscles. So soon after the slaughtering, the circulation, the blood flow will stop. Okay, so as much as possible blood is removed from the animal carcass to increase the edibility and keeping quality of meat, since blood is an ideal medium for the growth of spoilage microorganisms. So soon after slaughtering or killing of the animals, how much blood is possible, that much blood will be removed from the dead body or the carcass, because that if this blood is present, it may leads to early spoilage of the meat. Okay, so and also if blood is present, the edibility, the palatability, the eating quality of the meat will be reduced, and for that purpose completely the blood will be removed. Okay, so failure of blood circulation and its removal from the muscle tissue results in depleted oxygen supply to all the tissues, leading to depletion of ATP and creatine phosphatase level due to stoppage of electron transport chain and oxidative phosphorylation, and most importantly to onset of anaerobic metabolism of glycogen. So when the animal is killed, the respiration stops, and after killing the entire blood will be cleaned, and as a result the oxygen level is completely reduced, which will leads to reduced level of ATP production in mitochondria. So as a result, when ATP is not there, the oxidation process won't take place, that will leads to anaerobic metabolysis of glycogen, that is the glycogen will not be converted into carbon dioxide anymore, so it will be converted into lactic acid. So anabolic metabolism of glucose and breakdown of ATP by continuing action of sarcoplasmic ATPase leads to depletion of ATP and creatine phosphate, resulting in the onset of rigor mortis. On the other hand, breakdown of glycogen in the absence of oxygen leads to the production of lactic acid, thus decrease in the pH. So already which I have mentioned previously, the same flowchart is being explained here. So whenever the ATP production is depleted, it leads to the condition called as rigor mortis, about which you'll be studying in the next slides. And also it leads to conversion of glycogen into lactic acid, which results in increased pH level. Sorry, decreased pH level. And the other postpartum changes that takes place in the muscles are, first one, the change in the pH. So decrease in the pH due to lactic acid formation is accompanied by various exothermic reactions such as anaerobic glycolysis. So pH changes from physiological pH 7.2 to 7.4 to ultimately postmortem pH 5.3 to 5.5 in 24 hours. So this has profound effect on muscle protein of meat. Usually glycolysis ceases even before the glycogen is depleted. Okay, so first of all, due to the anaerobic condition which is created due to loss of the blood, the glycolysis will takes place, that is, it will be converted into lactic acid. As a result, pH will drop from neutral condition to acidic condition within one day. Okay, so next is change in temperature. So temperature of animal increases from 37.6 to 39 degrees Celsius. So this is the reason why animal cools slowly during refrigeration as a result of continuous production of heat. This phenomenon is known as animal heat, and removal of animal heat by chilling or refrigeration is essential to ensure longer shelf life of our meat. So after the slaughtering process, the temperature of the animal will increase from normal 37 degrees Celsius to around 39 degrees Celsius because of the various exothermic reaction which is taking place inside the body after the death. So because of this reason only, the slaughtered animals will be chilled or refrigerated, and this process of chilling will or freezing will helps in ensuring the long shelf life, because as you know, the high temperature is most favorable condition for microbial growth. And if we reduce this temperature, automatically the microbial spoilage can be reduced and the shelf life can be increased. Next is change in protein. So due to the change in pH and high temperature, color of the meat will changes and water holding capacity will also decrease. Sarcoplasmic proteins get denatured and attached to the surface of myofilament, which produces a change in meat color, which becomes light. So water holding capacity of myofibril protein decreases, resulting in exudation of fluids. So whenever there is a change in the pH and the temperature, obviously the color of the meat and the water holding capacity will decrease. So sarcoplasmic proteins like elastin, collagen will be denatured and it will be attached to the myofilament or myofibrillar filaments like actin and myosin. So which will produce the change in the meat color, as there is a combination of two types of protein, the color of the meat will also change. And even since the water holding capacity is also decreasing, the body fluids will ooze out from the dead body. Okay, so sarcoplasmic proteins are most labile with respect to physiological conditions prevailing in the postpartum muscles. These proteins are highly susceptible to disruption as compared to myofibrillar proteins. So sarcoplasmic proteins during rigor mortis denatured below pH 6 at 37 degrees Celsius. So sarcoplasmic proteins are highly stable usually, but when there is a pH change up to around 6 and there is a temperature change of around 37 degree, these proteins will be denatured. Now change in water holding capacity. So water holding capacity is the function of respective proteins which bind with water. So in pre-rigor stage, meat processes a high water holding capacity, but later it decreases during first hour following the death of animals. Lower water holding capacity is found at its isoelectric pH 5.3 to 5.5. After post rigor, aging water holding capacity is found to be increased because of increase in osmotic. So during postmortem moment of sodium, potassium, magnesium, calcium in muscle takes place, but during aging there is continuous release of sodium and calcium and uptake of potassium ion continued up to 6 to 8 days. The movement of cation produces an increased electrical charge on muscle protein which facilitated the formation of hydrated ions. So it is believed to be the reason of increased water holding capacity during the aging of meat. So water holding capacity of a protein is nothing but the ability of the muscle protein to hold the water. So before the death, the water holding capacity of the meat will be higher. So during the first few hours of the death of the animal, because of the lower pH, the water holding capacity will decrease, and during the postmortem, the ions like sodium, potassium, calcium and magnesium will be, the movement of these ions will take place for electronic balance. Okay, for around 6 to 8 days. So during this period, the hydrated ions will be moving, exchanging between the muscle protein. So as a result, during the aging, after the death of the animals, so the water holding capacity will increase. So next is the post-mortem glycolysis. So before the death, the glycogen will be converted into carbon dioxide and it will be expelled out, and after the death, this glycogen will be converted into lactic acid. So after the death of animals, the blood circulation stops, the oxygen supply to muscle tissues decrease, and hence anaerobic condition will prevail in the muscle. The glycogen present in tissue is no longer converted into carbon dioxide and water, instead converted into lactic acid through anaerobic glycolysis. So the conversion of glycogen takes place through different pathways, that is amylolytic pathway or hydrolytic pathway and phosphorylated pathway. So this conversion of glycogen to lactic acid can take place in two ways. So it can take place in amylolytic pathway or in phosphorylated pathway. So under amylolytic pathway, it will be converted into dextrin first, then maltose, and then it will be converted into glucose. So this same glucose will reach the second stage under phosphorylated stage. So wherein first it will be converted into glucose 1 phosphate, then it will be converted into glucose 6 phosphate, which is same glucose from amylolytic pathway. Later it will be broken down into fructose and then into dehydroxyacetone phosphate and glyceraldehyde phosphate, and finally it will be broken down into lactic acid, which may be further converted into pyruvic acid. So due to this glycolysis, pH will change from 7.2 to 7.4 to 5.5 to 5.3. So this pH is attained within 24 hours and being related to ATP production, which falls in this pathway. The net fall in ATP is responsible for onset of rigor mortis. The pH of 5.5 is ideal pH, which can be obtained by well-rested and well-fed animal before slaughter. So because of this glycogenic pathway, glycolysis pathway, the pH will be reduced, and even interrelated to this is ATP production. So even the ATP production will fall within 24 hours, within one day of the animal's death. And this fall in the ATP production leads to a condition called as rigor mortis. And this particular pH is a optimal pH for a slaughtered carcass, because and if the animals are properly fed and rested before they are slaughtered, this pH can be easily attained. That is about the changes which takes place during the after the death of the animals, that is change in the pH, change in the temperature, change in the pathway of glycogen breakdown, and also change in water holding capacity. Now let us see how the muscle of an animal will be converted into meat. Okay, so we call this process as rigor mortis. So the most important change that occur in postmortem muscle is the development of rigor mortis, that is the stiffness of the muscle. The primary cause of onset of rigor is postmortem decline in the level of ATP. So the process takes place from 7 to 24 hours depending on the species. However, it is linked with the rate of depletion of ATP in muscles. So the entire process of conversion of muscle into meat is broadly divided into three categories or three stages. So rigor mortis is nothing but the condition which is attained by the carcass after the death, resulting in the stiffness of the muscles. Okay, so the stiffness of muscle is mainly caused due to the decreased level of ATP. So since the blood circulation stops, the oxygen supply to the all the organs will stop, and as a result, in the absence of oxygen, ATP production cannot take place. So since this ATP or the energy is not available for contraction of the muscles will get stiffened, and this condition is called as rigor mortis, and it takes place within 7 to 24 hours of the death of the animal depending upon the species. There are basically three stages in rigor mortis. First one is pre-rigor stage. So during the early stages of postmortem or pre-rigor stage, the concentration of ATP more or less remains constant as the muscle tries to maintain ATP level by an active creatine kinase. However, it will lead to liberation of creatine from muscles. Thus, in this state, creatine phosphatase level fall more rapidly than that of ATPs. ATP are providing cushioning effect for the filaments of two proteins, that is actin and myosin. This results in a meat which is soft and pliable. So, in pre-rigor state, myosin dissociates from actin and can be extracted in solutions of high ionic strength. Water holding capacity of the muscle protein remains high during this stage. So during pre-rigor stage, what happens here, that is soon after the death of the animals, there will be some more amount of ATP, that is the level of ATP will be a bit high because muscle will try to maintain this level of ATP by the enzyme called as creatine kinase. But the problem is whenever this enzyme is active, creatine of the muscle will be released. Okay, so even though ATP production can be maintained with the help of creatine kinase, but creatine from the muscle will be released. As a result, what happened? The creatine phosphatase level will go down compared to your ATP. Okay, so the main function of ATP is it provides a cushioning effect. Also, it provides energy for contraction of the muscles. You know that contraction of the muscle is mainly because of the movement between actin and myosin, right? So you have already studied. So the actin and myosin, so when there is interaction or sliding movement of this actin and myosin, the muscles will contract, right? So this sliding process needs ATP to takes place. Okay, so when this particular process is going on, or when this particular muscle is alive, it gives a smooth and playable texture to the muscles. But in pre-rigor state, what happens? This myosin will dissociate. Okay, this myosin will get detached from the actin, and it can be even separated in a ionic solution. And even since soon after the death, there will be movement of electrons across the membrane, even the water holding capacity of these muscles protein will be higher. So in the rigor mortis stage, what happens? This is a very important, as meat becomes rigid and stiff. So onset of rigor mortis may be 8 to 10 hours post-mortem, and it may last in 15 to 20 hours in meat. So onset of rigor is demonstrated by fall in ATP, loss of extensibility of the muscles, contraction of tissues. So time difference between death of an animal and onset of rigor state is termed as the delay phase, and this period depends upon the factors such as age, health, size of carcass, the amount of fat cover, nutritional status of animal, pH, glycogen level, temperature as well. Okay, so rigor mortis is the period where the muscle become rigid and stiff, and it may takes place after 8 to 10 hours, as I said, depending upon the species, and it may last in 15 to 20 hours. So it may continue up to 15 to 20 hours in meat. So it will be a rigor process, or stiffness of muscle will be started by fall in the ATP and loss of extensibility and contraction. Okay, so it will be started soon when the ATP level falls down and the muscles will lose their ability to contract and extend. And this period between the death of the animal and the starting of rigor mortis is called as the delay period. And this period depends upon, so this period can be 7 hours to 24 hours. So this mainly depends upon what is the age of the animal which is killed, and how was the health, the size of the carcass, the amount of the fat which was present, and the nutritional state of the animal. So if it is poorly fed, then the rigor mortis can take place very quickly. If it is fed with well nourished food, then the rigor mortis may take some more extra time, and even the pH and glycogen level and the temperature as well. Now ATP plays a very important role in the stage. As ATP level falls, two muscle proteins gradually forms an associated actomyosin complex, which is inextensible and is responsible for contraction. This is the necessary criteria for development of rigor mortis. So soon after the ATP level comes down, the actin and myosin will dissociate, depart from each other and combine. That is, the moment will be lost, and together they will be called as now actomyosin complex. So this complex is responsible for rigidity and stiffness of the muscles. The extent of contraction of the muscle is determined by estimation of length of the sarcomere within the myofibril. So meat which is cooked this state is very tough in texture. The water holding capacity of the meat muscle protein remains minimum during this stage due to drop in pH as it comes closer to their isoelectric point, that is 5.3 to 5.5. If the ultimate pH falls too quickly, carcass wood should be warm adversely, affecting the water holding capacity and prevailing the partial denaturation of protein, resulting into pale, soft and exudative muscle, ultimately leading to lower yield of the meat. This is often encountered in pigs having sufficient reserves of glycogen. On the other hand, if inadequately feed or fasting animals having minimum reserve of glycogen is subjected for slaughtering. Dark form and dry meat is obtained, which is having pH not below 6 and is darker in color and susceptible for microbial growth. Okay. So now the meat which is cooked during this period, that is the meat which is purchased after 7 to 24 hours of the slaughtering, so they will be having a very tough texture. So you may call it as a fresh meat kodi anta heltiralla, so they may be stiff because they are subjected to rigor mortis condition because of the fall in the pH. And so if the pH falls very quickly soon after the death of the organism, the carcass will be warm, adversely affecting the water holding capacity and also denaturation of the protein. Okay, if the animals are fed with the very less nutritious fodder, then that time the pH will fall very quickly and also the water holding capacity will be less and even the protein denaturation will be more, and this type of condition leads to pale, soft and exudative muscle or the meat. Okay, usually which is observed in pigs having sufficient reserves of glycogen. Okay, so if the animals are properly fed, that is olle chanda maadi adakke meisi adakke grass ella tinsi proper rest ella kottu aamele animals anna slaughter maadidre, aga nimge olle pale color iruvanta soft iruvanta fluid amsha ella jaasti iruvanta flesh sigutte. Ade in case if you are taking a inadequately fed or fasting animal, yavudu upvasa ಇಟ್ಟಿರುವಂತಹ ಎನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ಅಥವಾ ಕಮ್ಮಿ ಆಹಾರ ಹಾಕಿರುವಂಥ ಎನಿಮಲ್ಸನ್ನು ನೀವು ಸ್ಲಾಟರ್ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ ಆಗ ಗ್ಲೈಕೋಜನ್ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರುವುದಿಲ್ಲ, ಆಗೇನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ದ ಮೀಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡಾರ್ಕ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡ್ರೈ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್, ಸೊ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ ಪಿ ಎಚ್, ಸೊ ಪಿ ಎಚ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅರೌಂಡ್ 6 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ದ ಡಾರ್ಕ್ ಕಲರ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಹಾರ್ಡ್ ಮೀಟ್. Okay, so only it is advised that so before slaughtering the animal, it has to be fed with the proper nutritious fodder. That is about the rigor mortis. The next condition is post rigor or conditioning. So during post rigor stage, meat become tenderizes and organoleptically acceptable when it is kept cold for some time after rigor mortis. So the muscle again becomes soft and pliable with improved flavor and juiciness. The post rigor meat provides lesser problem in toughness when cooked compared to than cooked in rigor. So meat gradually reaches to an optimum tenderness period after an aging period of 10 to 18 days stored at 0 to 5 degrees Celsius following the dissolution of rigor. However, prolonged storage of meat in some species may result in some problems, that is microbial spoilage, desiccations of proteins and development of off flavor. So thus it is recommended to consume meat before it gets spoiled. The aging, which also called as conditioning or ripening of meat, is sometimes accelerated by rising storage temperature. For example, holding meat at 15 degrees Celsius for 3 days period in UV to control the microbial growth at surface. While in case of pork, aging is not recommended, rather to eat fresh as it is, as it develops rapid onset of fat rancidity even at low temperature. On the other hand, beef is generally aged and lamb and muttons are occasionally aged. So post rigor stage is nothing but you are going to store it for further time so that to develop a soft and palatable texture in it. So during the post rigor stage, So it is said that the meat will become tender and organoleptically the flavor and the texture will also be improved if it is kept in cold for some time. And even during the post-rigor stage, the muscles will become soft and pliable, and there will not be a more problem in the cooking as the muscles have regained its smoothness or the tenderness. So usually the optimum tenderness period will be reached after 10 to 15, 18 days. That I said previously that the rigor stage may last for 15 to 20 hours. So after that, so it will be aged, that is it will be kept under storage, chill storage, that is around 0 to 5 degrees Celsius for 10 to 18 days, where the rigor condition will be reversed. Okay, the tough actomyosin will be converted into actin and myosin, and even because of these, the muscles will become soft and tender and juicy. However, there are problems like microbial spoilage or desiccation of proteins and development of off flavor if it is kept for more than 18 days, 10 to 18 days. So aging is also called as conditioning or ripening of the meat. So it can be accelerated, improved by giving UV treatment, which will also reduce the microbial spoilage. So for pork, aging is not recommended since the pork has a large fat which may easily undergo lipid oxidation, whereas beef and lamb and muttons are usually aged, not regularly but occasionally. So that is for today's class, that is what are the changes that takes place after the death of the animal, nothing but the postmortem changes. So we have studied there will be change in the pH, there will be change in the temperature, and there will be change in the arrangement of actin and myosin, and also the change in the glycolytic breakdowns, that is instead of glycolysis changing into glycogen changing into carbon dioxide and water, they will undergo hydrolytic and phosphorylated pathway to give rise to lactic acid. So which results in decrease in the pH from 7 to 5. As the pH is decreased, the water holding capacity will also decrease and the muscle will become tougher, which condition is called as the rigor mortis condition. So rigor mortis condition can take place in three stages: pre-rigor stage, rigor stage, and the post-rigor stage. So in pre-rigor stage, the ATP condition will be initially maintained by creatine kinase enzyme, because of which the creatine content will be reduced. So as a result, the muscles actin and myosin will be detached and form a complex called as actomyosin, which will give the tough nature to the muscle. So in the rigor stage, the toughness of the muscle will be continued for 15 to 20 hours, and during this period water holding capacity will be reduced, and if the animals are properly fed with the nutritious fodder and given proper rest, it will give to the pale, soft, juicy meat. And if the animals are not properly fed and if they are a fasting animals, it leads to dry condition, dry dark meat. So after that, after rigor stage, they'll be subjected to chilling so that they'll obtain their tenderness. So this chilling can be done for beef, mutton, lamb. But for pig, it is not recommended because pig consists of more fat, which may lead to lipid oxidation. So that is for today's classes. If you have any doubts or queries, you can text me or call me, and try to submit your assignment by today itself and send it to my mail ID. Okay. Thank you. Have a nice day.